Now we'll take a look at two more examples of adding integers, and we'll first use the money analogy to find the sum, and then we'll use the formal rules for adding integers to find the sum. For positive 12 plus negative 3, because this 12 is positive and this 3 is negative, we can think of the sum as winning $12, and then we add a loss of $3. Well, if we win $12 and then lose $3, we're still ahead $9, so the sum would be positive 9. Notice how the positive number outweighs the negative, resulting in a positive sum. So using the formal rules to add integers, there's two cases. One when you're summing two integers with different signs, as we see here, and another rule when we're adding integers with the same sign, as we see here. So if the integers have a different sign, we subtract their absolute values and then use the sign of the number that has a larger absolute value. And if the integers are the same sign, we add the absolute values and we keep the sign of the original integers. So for here, the absolute value of 12 is 12, and the absolute value of negative 3 is 3. So we subtract the smaller number from the larger number, so we have 12 minus 3, which is equal to 9. And again, the reason it's positive is because the 12 is positive and it has the larger absolute value. But again, logically it makes sense because the 12 is positive and it's outweighing the negative 3. For negative 15 plus negative 9, we could think of this as losing $15 and then adding another loss of $9. Well, if we lose $15 and then we lose $9, we have a total loss of $24, so the sum is negative 24. And again, using the formal rules, we would take the absolute value of both, and then because the integers have the same sign, we actually add their absolute values. So this would be 24, but because the original integers were both negative, the sum isn't positive 24, it's actually negative 24. We'll take a look at two more examples in the next video.